Fans, we'd like to thank you for braving the weather tonight and arriving on the campus of Western Washington University, the mecca of NCAA Division II men's college basketball. Tonight, your Vikings play host to the Alaska Anchorage Seawolves. To begin tonight's activities, we would like to begin by acknowledging that we gather tonight on the ancestral homelands of the Coast Salish peoples, who have lived in the Salish Sea Basin throughout the San Juan Islands and North Cascades watershed from time immemorial. Please join us in expressing our deepest respect and gratitude for our indigenous neighbors, the Lummi Nation and Nooksack Tribe, for their enduring care and protection of our shared lands and waterways. Fans, at this time, we'd like to ask you to rise, if you are able, and remove your hats. It's time now to honor America with the playing of our national anthem. Now let's meet the starting lineups for tonight's contest. First, the visitors, the Alaska Anchorage Seawolves. At forward, a 6'7 senior, number 3, Sawyer Storms. At guard, a 6'2 senior, number 11, Tyson Gilbert. At guard, a 6'3 senior, number 20, Dathan Satchel. At guard, a 6'1 junior, number 30, Dylan Barrientos. And at forward, a 6'7 freshman, number 32, Sloan Lentfer. Alaska Anchorage is coached by Rusty Osborne. Six man, put your hands together. It's time to meet the starting lineup for your Vikings. At guard, a 6'4 junior, number 1, KJ Kai Johnson. At forward, a 6'9 senior, number 13, Jonathan Ned. At forward, a 6'9 junior, number 20, Nick Velp. At forward, a 6'9 sophomore, number 23, B.J. Colley. And at guard, a 6'4 junior, number 44, Will Wilson. Your Vikings, they're coached by Tony Dominguez. He is assisted by A.J. Albright, Bob Hofstetter, and Otavio Jude. Six man, it's Game Time!
Hello and welcome into Carver Gym. Thank you for tuning in to Vikings TV. My name is Adam Race alongside Butch Kamina. Well, Bellingham is covered in snow, but it is warm and dry here on the WECU court, and we have a really interesting matchup here. Truly an unstoppable force versus an immovable object. Western Washington coming into this game, top 5 in Division 2 in scoring. University of Alaska Anchorage, the visitors, top two in scoring defense. Butch, take me through this matchup.
This should be a fun one. It always is. UAA, always a good defensive team. Hey, we got Anchorage weather for an Anchorage matchup tonight. Should be fun.
This is a highly anticipated game in a week that is full of good GNAC matchups. St. Martin's and Montana State Billings going at it. And this, a game between two opposing teams with very different philosophies. As early on, we see the defense there going to ground and drawing the charge is Dylan Barrientos. Barrientos, the transfer out of Santa Clarita, California from College of the Canyons, has been lighting it up as of late. It's a UAA offense that hasn't been extremely efficient this year, but in the last few games in this four-game win streak they put together, Barrientos has been a big part of that. Anchorage goes the other way past the swat of B.J. Colley and putting in it is Sloan Lentfer, the Anchorage native and the freshman forward. First points of the game for the visitors. Wilson dumps it into Nick Velp. Three defenders ahead of him. They get it in the corner. Kai Johnson for three. Yes! And that's the question. If the Vikings can get the three-point ball working, it'll make a huge difference. UAA leads the nation in defense against the three-pointer. They're only giving up a 23% three-point percentage. The response is off the mark. Pulling up there was Dathan Satchel, but no good and out of bounds. Vikings ball.
70 of 270, just 25.9%. So they're not just holding you to a low percentage. They're not giving up many shots from there either. And that's only about, trying to do the quick math here, about 16 a game.
It's the best percentage in Division II. It would be the best percentage in Division I as well. Really an outstanding number. B.J. Colley drives in. Can't get through the sea of bodies. The steal. Barrientos brings it down the floor. Hands it off to Tyson Gilbert. Steps back for three. Can't get it. Rebound falls to Nick Velp. In and out of the hands of Sawyer Storms. But Storms takes it right back. Barrientos holds it and slows things down. Early on here, Vikings getting some turnover trouble.
This is a team that will grind you. They are more than happy to work to the single-digit parts of the shot clock to get a look.
Alaska Anchorage has only allowed a team to score 80 or more one time this season. A nice move by Gilbert. Gives him room at the elbow, but he can't get the wide-open jumper to fall. B.J. Colley pulls down the board. Move it ahead to Ned. Back to Will Wilson. Wilson kicks it out at the top to Nick Velp. Hits the floor. And Kai Johnson will slow it down. Working around a screen from B.J. Colley. Gets the switch onto the larger Lentfer. Drives in. Pulls up from the free throw line. Ooh. And hits.
Tough shot.
Those are the tough shots we've been seeing from Kai Johnson this year. From mid-range, he has been electric. He's got the first 5 points of the game for Western Washington. On that road trip, he had an outstanding game against Montana State Billings. Slowed down, and the Vikings lost against Seattle Pacific. Vikings currently on their longest skid of the year, losing three straight, starting with the last home game they played here against St. Martin's, a shootout that they ended up on the worst end of. Barrientos drives in, gets the lay-in.
As you said, playing very well of late. 10.5 points, close to 4 assists a contest.
Jonathan Ned brings it around on a crosser with Will Wilson, now hands it off to Kai Johnson. Johnson finds Ned open for three, hits it.
Very nicely constructed play. They run the pick and roll off of that weave action. And when that wing defender has to dive down to help the roll, it leaves Wilson wide open.
Two quick threes in this game against the best defensive three-point team in the nation. Good signs early here for the Vikings.
Excuse me, Ned wide open.
Looking for a response and not getting it there was Dathan Satchel, and misses his second three-pointer of the night. Rebound goes off of Sawyer Storms, and the Vikings will take over.
You see it again. The rolling Velp pulls the defender in. Gilbert leaving Ned open in the corner for the three.
Three-point shooting has been a good point for the Vikings on offense this year. There hasn't been much of this offense that hasn't been clicking. 93 points per game is fifth in Division II. As that pass sails way over the head of Jonathan Ned, out of bounds. Will Wilson got in trouble and couldn't get out of it cleanly.
So to give you a sense of how these two teams play, both have played 16 games, and the total field goal attempts in the Viking games is over 2,000. It's almost 2,100, 2,087. UAA, it's just barely over 1,700, 1,713. So like somewhere in the neighborhood of 370 more shots have been taken in those 16 games for the Vikings. So we're looking at a 24 or 25 more shot attempts for both teams over the course of a game.
Vikings have pushed the pace a number of times this season. Three-pointer there from Sawyer. Storms rolls out. Fighting to try to get the rebound there was Dathan Satchel, but Kai Johnson came out with it. Jonathan Ned wants another three-pointer. This time it doesn't fall. Seawolves grab the rebound.
I don't think that's a bad shot. And you want to try to up the pace a little bit. He's squared up. He's got a good look. That's a good look for John Ned. No problem with all that.
That pass is deflected, but getting to it first is Sawyer Storms, one of the several seniors on this lineup, a very experienced Seawolves team. Barrientos hands it off here to Tyson Gilbert, and he gets the first tray of the game for the visitors. Gilbert, the leading scorer this season so far for Alaska Anchorage at around 13.5 points per game, an efficient three-point shooter. Cross-court passes over the head of Will Wilson. And once again, the turnover is getting the Vikings in trouble as that leads to our first media timeout with Western Washington holding the 8-7 lead. We'll be right back.
To them, the whole world looks like an opportunity, one to be seized, built upon, and made better for their sport and the people around it. To student athletes, every opportunity is a chance to change what could be and show the world what opportunity can do.
Welcome back to Sam Carver Gymnasium, WECU Court. And in a matchup tonight, Adam, that points out the geographic vastness of the GNAC and of the West region as a whole. I mean, think about how many states, when you look across the whole region and the three conferences, Anchorage and Fairbanks and Billings and the Hawaii schools, and you can go all the way down to Point Loma. And I mean, you think about the difference between Fairbanks and Point Loma, one almost on the tundra and another one with those incredible sunsets on the Pacific over the cliff, and it is, hey, give me my choice, I'll take sunsets over the cliff in Point Loma or even on Mission Beach or something like that anytime I can.
So yeah, just shows the vastness of sports here in America, something unheard of outside of this country. Is a great dish finds Tyson Gilbert, and he gives UAA the first lead of the game.
Outside 2-0. Of when that team in Vladivostok plays in the first division in Russia, but that's a weird one.
Russia might be the only competitor there. Nick Valve, Isaac Moreau into the game. Gives it off to Ned. That one is short.
That's a really unusual one, though.
When you talk about in Britain, soccer fans complaining about driving 2 hours to get to a game. That's a commute for some people around here.
Yeah, even a Sunderland supporter like me would own the longest drive, and from the corner there is about 6 or 7 hours, right?
It does get tiring hearing people complain about that.
It is a matter of perspective.
Barrientos pulls up for three and doesn't get it to go. Foul on the rebound will go against Isaac Moreau. Moreau has been playing effectively off the bench this year. He was pretty good on the road trip. Shot efficiently, did a little bit of everything in the games against MSUB and SPU. And it's a three-game losing streak for this Vikings team that has had some pretty frustrating games because the offense really hasn't stopped throughout this season. It's just been some lapses on defense, on rebounding, and just not being able to pull things out.
With the exception of that Hawaii Pacific game, they've scored just about consistently just about every night. Just haven't been able to get the consistency at the defensive end. And, a week and a half ago, the Vikings, if you look at some of the numbers at least, their actual regional rankings aren't out yet, we're right there. And now they've fallen back and are going to have to climb their way back up again. This is a UAA team that's kind of right on that bubble right now. It's obviously early to be thinking about bubbles, but just to give you a sense of where they're at, and they're on a four-game winning streak. So
UAA won their first eight games of the season, were ranked in the national top 25 before dropping their first two GNAC games against Billings and SPU, as Kai Johnson's off on that one. Swatting at it is Isaac Moreau, but it comes out in favor of the Seawolves. Moving in transition, a block by B.J. Colley that ended up going in. They're going to count it as a goaltend. It went in anyway. And, looks like B.J. Colley's down in some pain.
Well, the ball actually went in.
Yes, it went in off the glass. B.J. Colley looked to be in a good amount of pain, something you really don't like to see. Already a season that's been cut a little short by injuries.
And that has been the difficult thing for B.J. Colley. When he has been healthy, he has, throughout his career, he has been outstanding. And just maintaining that health has been the difficult thing.
It looks like B.J. Colley will be replaced by Jordan Tate as of now, as he's still receiving treatment down under the basket. B.J. Colley, of course, that excellent freshman season, winning GNAC Freshman of the Year. He's just really starting to hit his stride after missing some games early this season with injuries. We can take another look at it here. Oh.
Ouch.
That's credit to the replay room for getting that up, but that's not fun to watch at all. So he's going to get to the locker room with the help of a couple teammates.
And not putting our very minimal weight, maybe.
Certainly twisted the ankle coming down. Well, we'll hope that B.J. Colley, that it's not too serious. Looks like he might be not coming back tonight, but hopefully can make a return soon. Such an important part of this team, a great player, great student. That one rims around by Jonathan Ned. Jordan Tate is going to ask for a jump ball. He's going to get it on the rebound there, a contested rebound. Possession arrow is in favor of Alaska Anchorage, but that'll at least switch the possession arrow. Tate crashed the offensive board. Mistimed the jump there on the roll, but was able to get two hands on it. Barrientos controls it, guarded by Sane. Sloan Lentfer hands it off to Barrientos, sets a screen, space to shoot, and can't connect on that one. Another tie-up on the rebound, but coming out with it is Hassan Harrington. Barrientos wants another three, and finally hits his first of the night. He's been red-hot coming into this one. He was 9 of his last 14 coming into tonight from three. And after a handful of attempts, he gets the first to fall. UAA has built up a six-point lead here. It's been the offensive consistency that's been more tough for Rusty Osborne's team this year, as Kai Johnson looks for the response. A little bit short. Ned comes down with the offensive board on a nice tip by Jordan Tate. So the two GNAC games that UAA dropped, they played excellent defense, but just weren't able to have that offensive rhythm and consistency. It's a desperate fast finds. Seawolf driving in and rolling it in is Dylan Barrientos. He's got two straight buckets now.
And he's up to 9 points already.
He was the offensive player of the watch, player to watch coming into this game for UAA. Jonathan Ned hounded, tries to give it off to Tijon Sane. They want a tip, and they're going to get it. So the ball will stay at that end of the court as Will Wilson checks back in, and that'll head to the second media timeout here. UAA, a little scoring explosion, puts them up six here. We'll be right back.
You are.
Quick 12-2 run from the visitors has them up 6 here. Western Washington with the ball. Trying to cut into this small lead here.
Vikings 4 of 9 from the field, 2 of 5 from 3, but already 5 turnovers.
And we talked earlier about how you'd expect to see Western Washington get off a lot more shots, but the thing that's going to get in the way of that is if they can control the ball or not. UAA is extremely good at taking care of the ball. They do not turn the ball over very often. They get a lot of assists, and that's a big part of their game offensively. Will Wilson, a contested three-pointer, and hits it. Hand in the face from Tyson Gilbert. Did not bother Wilson. He was the Vikings' leading scorer in their last game against SPU. Seems every game the Vikings have played, the leading scorer has been either Will Wilson or Kai Johnson. One or the other has seemed to always step up as far as putting points on the board. Layup there by Hassan Harrington.
Hassan Harrington from Anchorage, but played a couple years at UT Tyler, redshirted a year, and then played a year.
Part of a couple transfers in this lineup. Three-pointer there from Jordan Tate off the mark. Rebounded by Jerron Williams. Williams has been a very important piece off the bench for this Seawolves team. Another Elastica Anchorage native. Previous transfer from Spokane Community College. Again in the hands of Harrington again. Guarded by Sane. Blair hits the floor. Play continues though. Harrington can't get the short two-point shot to go. Jordan Tate pulls down the rebound. They move ahead with Sane. The three-point specialist handles around a couple of Seawolves. Gets Kai Johnson open for three. Yes! So all of a sudden, the Vikings bring it back to a two-point game. They've hit three of their last four shots, as have the visitors. Barrientos getting off here to Williams. And back now to Harrington. Barrientos works around a screen, passes it off to Harrington. Driving in on Will Wilson. Well boxed out. Has to kick it out to Sawyer Storms. 5 on the shot clock. Great pass. Finds Tyson Gilbert to lay it in. Looks nice. Like the Vikings had that possession. They had gotten the shot clock way down. But as you said, Butch, this is a UAA team that is comfortable with those long possessions.
Perfect backdoor cut and a great look by Sawyer Storms.
Storms, a player who can do a little bit of everything out there and has for a couple years now for UAA. As a turnover there. Picked up by Williams. Driving the other way. Tate with the foul and one. And they're going to, I believe they're going to call that on the floor.
Have a look here.
So there'll be no shot there. It was close. Getting the shot up in a hurry was Williams trying to go to the line. But it'll just be personal.
I don't completely understand that call. Now, there was a bit of a gather, but I still think he's bringing that ball up to finish as he gets bumped. But
perhaps a bit of a fortunate call there for the Vikings instead of a foul and one, which would be a baseline inbound for the Seawolves. They inbound it here to Sawyer Storms.
I understand what the official is saying there. But it's just a very tight interpretation that most of the time you don't see.
Williams. Pass it off to Tyson Gilbert. And that's going to be an offensive foul. Sawyer Storms caught Tijon Sane on a screen. It'll be going the other way.
Yeah, he tried to roll just a little bit too early. And Tijon Sane was there, and Storms ran through him. We'll see it.
Lay down the shoulder on Sane there.
Turned, and he got him with the hip.
Tend to see that pretty often from Sane. Definitely not the biggest player on the court. He tends to take a beating on those picks. And that time, the floater from Kai Johnson can't go. Offensive board by Isaac Moreau can't get the putback to fall. And there's going to be a foul. And it's going to go against Jordan Tate. So two quick fouls for Tate off the bench.
A great effort by Isaac Moreau there to get that rebound in traffic, but just couldn't find an angle to go up strong. He was able to get the shot off, but he had to be kind of off balance to do it and wasn't able to finish.
And that high intensity, high effort is Moreau's MO, driving in and getting those offensive boards. Williams, a little shove on Tate there. No whistle, though. Tyson Gilbert, 12 on the shot clock. Barrientos backs it up to the Viking. He's got to shoot here. He's guarded by Tate. A couple crossovers, drives in, tipped by Moreau, put up into the air, into the bench. It's going to go out of bounds. It'll be Seawolves ball, but 1 second remaining on the shot clock. So interesting to see what UAA can do here with the 1 second on the shot clock. Not a situation you practice very often.
As much time as you have in the preseason, you find a way to get a couple of these things in.
Nathan Satchel to inbound, throws it long to the other side. Williams was able to get the shot up.
It's a well-designed play. It's as good a look as you can ask for in that situation.
Falls short. And the foul on the drive there against Will Wilson, that'll be on the floor.
You would think that a very detailed coach like Rusty Osborne is over the course of the preseason and during the season, they've got a couple things in that you're going to get a quick look. It's going to happen a few times. Not normally on the sideline, maybe more on the baseline, but
Osborne, one of the more veteran coaches, two of the more veteran coaches in the GNAC on the floor right now, Antonio Dominguez and Osborne. Osborne in his 19th season, 340 wins with the Seawolves. As Wilson drives in and straight to the hoop to draw the foul on a spin move. He'll go to the line.
Actually had a chance to talk to Rusty Osborne earlier this year. It was up in Anchorage with Western Volleyball and Cross Country, and he was at the volleyball match. Sometimes after you've been around the league for a long time with people, you start to recognize them and know them. And good guy, Rusty. Very intense, but off the floor, very, very good guy to talk to.
Staple of collegiate athletics up in Anchorage.
Yeah, was an assistant for a long time before he took the head job as well.
Wilson is able to hit both his free throws, bring it down to a one-point game. A two-point game.
They've always got some wrinkles. Some years when they aren't particularly doing well, they'll come in here and they will basically hold the ball until the 10-second mark on the shot clock to slow the game down. Shorten the number of possessions, and not seeing that tonight. They're just playing their standard methodical way in the half court, but that's a nice shot.
And
good post up.
A good little hook shot there from Sloan Lentfer. Got a fortunate bounce. Makes it 18-22. These two teams split the season series last year. Both teams won in their road games. As Ned is going to be called for the offensive foul there. Driving in against Tyson Gilbert. CSU Pueblo transfer, Colorado native. That'll bring us to a media timeout with 7 minutes, 34 seconds remaining here on Vikings TV. Back here at Carver Gym, UAA has built up a small four-point lead. And somewhere in between the first and second media timeout, about 50 students have arrived into the stands. The Carver Crazies have come out here on a snowy Bellingham day to support the Vikings.
Yeah, we just all of a sudden looked up as we went to the timeout. It's like, when did they get here? We didn't see them.
Unsurprisingly, was a sparse attendance coming in with the conditions outside, but they've shown up here with 10 minutes gone.
As we said, if you're on campus, why not?
You
get yourself across. There's nothing else going on right
either
now.
Either do this or go sledding.
I imagine over the last 2 days, people have sledded themselves out.
Might as well come inside, enjoy the warmth of Carver Gym and some GNAC basketball.
I do have a steep driveway. I did give it some thought, but at 57, I just thought this is not wise. It did not.
Too much risk.
Sledding. Yeah. Well, even if there's no risk, even if I don't crash, I'd be hurting afterwards, right? Now that the boys have moved out, I could still make my token appearance when I still had kids in the house, but no longer.
I'm only 20. My sledding days are far behind me. Sloan Lentfer brings it down the other way. Belp giving him space to the top. Lentfer is a player who does shoot the three occasionally, but Well, giving him the space, the perimeter, and a high lollipop shot from Dathan Satchel falls. Satchel's first bucket of the night. Wilson in transition, gets the defender in the air, drives in, kicks it out to Ned. Tijon Sane fakes the pass. He goes in, passes deflected as far as Will Wilson. Wilson, three Seawolves around him, falling away, and he's not going to get the shot. That's going to be another one called on the floor. He got the contested jumper to go.
So we'll give this official credit. He's consistent at both ends of the floor because this is another one. This one's probably a little earlier, especially if he's if he calls that on Lentford, no. But again, those are about equal at both ends of the floor. It's consistent. Good enough. You ask for that, right?
So now both teams perhaps wanting and one opportunities and not getting them as Velt crashes to the rim and throws it down. Well, Nick Velt, we can talk about it over and over again. What a breakout season he is having here.
Yeah. Wait, just kind of slid across the baseline. Nobody picked him up and flush it down.
He's got four double-doubles on the season, second most in the GNAC. Another elbow shot there from Gilbert, gets it to go. Tyson Gilbert now at 9 points to lead all scorers. Pinked at 11 points on 5 of 7 shooting.
I like what I've seen from Tyson Gilbert so far.
He averages 13 points a game, already 11 for him as Louis Grant Holiday into the game, turns it over. Gilbert gets the steal on the other end. That's the thing about this Seawolves team. Every player on the floor is an excellent defender. There's no weak points as far as defense goes. Gilbert hands it off to Trey Evans, the freshman out of South Jordan, Utah. Back to Gilbert. He's been running through him a lot of this first half. Gets a move out of Velp and drives in to lay it in. That is a really nice
switching
move.
Switching hands at the end. He had a dribble in the left hand, and as he went up, switched to the right to get around the defender and finish.
He had Nick Velp guessing at the top, and it gave him space to drive in, and that nice move at the rim as Tijon Sane is going to shoot two. Tijon Sane, of course, hugely talented three-point shooter, but he does have that ability to drive in and draw contact.
Here's Gilbert again, a little head fake. Go up, switch it to the right, get around Will Wilson, very nice.
Sane, an excellent free throw shooter on the season. Coming in with an 89% clip from the charity stripe.
Westman's women won at St. Martin's tonight, and when Olivia Wickstrom stepped to the line 20 for 20, the announcer talked about jinxing her, and she made two, and he says, oh, well, she must be really good to overcome that.
Something we have not been able to escape is the announcer's jinx this season. Sane hits one.
We've hit the whammy on a whole lot of people this year, haven't we?
Yes, we have. Vikings getting the job done down in Lacey, though. A low-scoring game that the nationally ranked women's team is able to win as Grant Holiday picks up a steal going the other way, clear the runway, throws it down. And that'll force a timeout out of Rusty Osborne as the Vikings have brought it back to 23-28, and that'll be a media timeout. We'll stay here for it as we look again at Grant Holiday on the steal. That's something he's really provided a lot of on the bench is the ability to get those steals and transition buckets. Well, Butch, 23-28 here, UAA in the lead. What have you seen out of this one?
The battle here is for pace, right? And for the most part, UAA has been able to dictate pace. But the Vikings have gone out a little bit in transition. You got a couple buckets there. And I think that's kind of the key for Western tonight. Can you keep this game at a higher pace, speed UAA up a little bit? Boy, they come down and they're so methodical, and they're very good at it, and it's something that they've done for a long time. You know, they'll take some opportunity transition, but once it gets into the half court, it just grinds you to death. And so the Vikings have to find a way to speed up the game. Some success in that so far, but maybe not enough.
Tony Dominguez keeping the rotation going here. Darius Gary coming into the game for the first time. Losing your first string center in B.J. Cauley early in this one. A lot of heroics off the bench might be needed. Gilbert gets to his spot again and hits it.
This is a mid-range clinic from Tyson Gilbert.
15 points already. It's Kai Johnson, the response on the other end.
He's up to 11.
Kai Johnson into double-digit scoring. Continues his streak of at least 10 points in every single game this season, the 20-point-per-game scorer. Barrientos gets it back to Gilbert, passed it off now to Lentford. Sawyer Storms on the ball. Barrientos left a little bit of space, but he leaves it short. Johnson runs the transition. Good pass ahead to Grant Holiday, and one.
And as you said a moment ago, he does it off the defensive end, but Louis Grant Holiday gets out in transition. It's something that, yeah, he doesn't hesitate. He goes. And there, Kai Johnson finding him with a long lead. Grant Holiday getting the bucket and the extra.
Kai Johnson, of course, you talk about his scoring, but he's been an excellent distributor this year as well. One of the top assisters in the GNAC. As Grant Holiday completes the old-fashioned three-point play.
Yeah, he's just a couple of ticks behind Barrientos at not quite four a game, so.
Barrientos pass it off here to Harrington, guarded by Jonathan Ned. Back to Barrientos. Sawyer storms, looking for space against Moreau. Crossover gets him a little bit of space, but hands it off to Barrientos in front of the Vikings student section. Six on the shot clock, once again bringing it all the way down here in the hands of Barrientos. Drives in, floater, no good. And there's going to be a foul call. That'll be an offensive foul along with the miss. Barrientos ran hard into Kai Johnson. Johnson a little bit shaken up. No worse for wear, though. And that'll lead to a media timeout. Well, the lead has been cut down to just one here, 29-30 UAA when we return.
The Teaching Learning Academy is an organization that's housed in the library, and it's where people come to have conversations.
They deal with serious issues that have emotional impact in ways that are typically not found in a class.
We've talked about diversity and inclusivity on our campus and in our community.
It not only enriches my education, but also impacts the ways that I can continue my leadership roles.
Fans here in Carver Gym trying to stay warm. Impressive being able to show up to these games. We thought for a while you and me weren't going to be able to make it to Carver Gym here with about a foot of snow on the ground. But hey, the fans have come out to support. The Carver Crazies are in attendance, and they're hyped up to be here.
Cold. It's 13 degrees in Anchorage right now.
I was going to say, the players on the visitors team, this is a vacation for them.
Yeah, the high Sunday is projected to be 5.
Definitely spoiled here in the Pacific Northwest, always mild.
Or maybe they're just suffering in Anchorage, but.
Great pass from Grant Holiday, finds Kai Johnson. He's gonna be called for a goaltend there on the attempted layup, so that will be a good basket here on a nice cut and pass, and that one did go off the backboard before getting swatted by Hassan Harrington, so that'll count and give the Vikings back the lead. Great pass finds Harrington there. He puts it away. Found by Sawyer Storms. Pass it ahead
It had been an 8-2 burst before that lay-in.
Johnson drives all the way around the baseline, gets it out to Ned, around a couple of defenders. Mid-range shot, he's fouled, and one on the jumper.
Let's see, I'm not sure. It is. He got hit on the head. Where the official was looking, I almost thought he was going to call something with Moreau and Storms down low, or Lenfer down low, excuse me. But
and you see how much it helps to have a offensive player like Kai Johnson who's able to just drive in there and suck in the defense, get space for Ned there. He's not able to complete the three-point play. Moreau just unable to get to the offensive board.
Kai Johnson has gravity. He sucks things to him just by his presence.
Player who can score from all parts of the court on offense. Can't give him a bit of space anywhere. Son Harrington at the top with 10 on the shot clock now. Barrientos passes it off. Sawyer Storms shot fake. Now he does pull up for three. That one's long and rebounded by Moreau, trying to get out in transition here. Storms hits the floor, so it's a 4-on-5 for a second. Kai Johnson trying to take advantage of the numbers, and he is going to get a foul call. Harrington went to the ground. I think he wanted an offensive foul, but it went against him on the block instead. Wasn't able to set his feet in time.
Yeah, man, he doesn't actually ever establish in front of Kai Johnson, so even though he kind of gets popped in the torso, which sometimes can lead to an offensive foul, he was not there.
Johnson to the line now. Kai Johnson's shooting 80% from the line this season. Western Washington has jumped to the best free throw shooting team in the GNAC right now. Alaska Anchorage at the bottom of that statistical category in the conference, shooting just above 60% as a team.
Kai Johnson gets there a lot too, 6.7 free throws a game. So, and then you shoot over 80%. That's a very efficient way to score.
Adds up. Johnson off on the second free throw. Moreau battling for it. He's going to be called for a foul. Second foul against Isaac Moreau. Now, one thing I love about Isaac Moreau is he always seems to have a smile on his face. Even after committing a foul, he always seems to find the funny side of it. Barrientos working at the logo. Jordan Tate getting set to come back in alongside Nick Velp. Down low to Storms. Find Harrington. Driving in and kicking back out. Nobody there, but Barrientos able to get to it. 8 on the shot clock. It's going to be another one winding down with a ball in the hands of Barrientos. Fakes the shot. Finds an open Gilbert for 3. No good. Back iron. Rebounded by the Vikings. Kai Johnson sprinting up the court. Straight at the hoop. Can't get it, but the putback is good. And 1!
And that is the essence of these two teams tonight, right? UAA ran the clock down. Multiple screens, multiple actions. Finally got a look from Gilbert, their best scorer tonight. And Western, they were up the floor in about 4 seconds. Kai Johnson misses the layup, but John Ned there for the putback and an opportunity for the and one.
Absolutely right. That is just a microcosm of the difference between these two teams. That's about as fast as I've seen Kai Johnson sprint up the floor with the ball in his hands. He was flying.
It's the old Phoenix Suns, Mike D'Antoni philosophy that A.J. Albright is into 7 seconds or less, man.
Not letting this elite defense get set. It's perhaps helped the Vikings get to it. They've got 37 here. So they're below their scoring mark on average for the season, but above what teams have been averaging against UAA. We've seen the Seawolves team hold teams to 20 points in the first half on many occasions this year. Like we said, only giving up 80 points one time all season. Bounce pass, finds Nick Velp, gets a defender in the air and puts it away.
Oh, Barrientos got put in the popcorn machine there. A little fake from Velp, and Barrientos was over on the sideline.
Velp at 4 points now and 2-2 shooting to go along with a team-leading 3 rebounds. Barrientos hands it off to Gilbert. Just over a minute remaining in the first half here. Pass just gets beyond Darius Gary, out to Sawyer Storms, back to Gilbert. Seawolves not able to find a clean look, just able to keep it in to Harrington. Storms for 3. Yes.
Boy, you did everything you want, but Sawyer Storms still hits that 3.
Sawyer Storms, not a huge scorer, but he is able to hit the 3-pointer. Ned from the corner, he gets one and points straight to the bench.
And you've talked about 80 points, so now Westman's at 42 in the first half, so on pace to reach that 80.
30 seconds remaining, 9-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Harrington not able to get it. Rebounded instead by Lentfer. He doesn't get the putback to go. Still with the Seawolves. Defensive rebounds have been a problem this season for Western Washington, and it gifts UAA another possession, perhaps the last shot of this first half.
Yeah, almost certainly. They're going to run this thing down. There's about a second and a half difference, maybe 2, between shot and game.
Barrientos gives it off to Gilbert. Pulls up as the shot clock goes. Doesn't get it, and that'll do it for the first half. Western Washington on a run to end the half have a 7-point lead against UAA, 42-35. A very good first half for the hosts. We'll have a halftime interview with A.J. Albritton and Zen Hill for you in just a second.
Joined here at halftime with assistant head coach A.J. Albritton. A.J., what an end of that first half. You guys are up over a good Alaska Anchorage team. Talk about what was good to end the half. Yeah, they're quick, and they like to run around, and you got to work. You got to continue to talk. And so we were able to talk later in that half, and I think that kind of was the reason why we're seeing that 35 points. If you run around and talk and run with them, stay connected, you can do a good job, and we're doing that.
Alaska Anchorage is statistically the best defensive team in the GNAC, but you're shooting 62% in the first half. Talk about what you've been able to find offensively out there.
Yeah, I mean, one thing that works with us, and we were doing it earlier on in the year, we're getting back to it. We're getting stops, you know, and we get stops. Our offense is very powerful. We were able to do that if we get stops and rebound, and we're doing that. So those two things allow us to get the points we usually get, and so we're doing it, and they are good defensively, but hopefully we can keep doing that in the second half.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck in the second half. Vikings second half coming up next on Vikings TV.
It's important that what I do as a job is something that I find meaningful. I ended up applying to the cybersecurity program at Western. The aspects of the program that really stand out to me is the hands-on experience.
Being able to work interdisciplinary and bring cybersecurity to marine science, bring it to communications, bring it to everything, is what really makes it interesting.
Welcome back into Carver, Jim. Thank you for tuning in to Viking TV. Adam Race alongside Butch Kamina. The first half here, elite offense versus elite defense. And right now, Western Washington holding a seven-point lead over visitors. University of Alaska Anchorage hit 9 of their last 10 shots to end that first period of play. Things are looking really good right now. But, Butch, let's go over the stats for that first half.
Yeah, interesting half. Kai Johnson led the way for Western with 14. Jonathan Ned with 13. On the other side, Tyson Gilbert with 15. We'll come back to some of those other individual numbers in a moment, but we see the team numbers on the screen. The Vikings shot 62% in the first half. Keep in mind that UAA holds their opponents to 41.4%, so UAA also shot 50%, so they did well as well. Maybe the big difference, the three-pointers. The Vikings 6 of 10, UAA 3 of 15. Western also with a 15-10 advantage on the boards. The Vikings did have 8 turnovers to just 4 for UAA, and UAA only turns the ball over about 11 or 12 times a game. Assists are even. As we said, Kai Johnson, 14 points, 3 assists. John Ned, 13 points, 3 assists. And then a little bit of a drop-off, 5 for Will Wilson, 5 for Louis Grant Holiday, 4 for Nick Velp, and a point for Tijon Sain. At the other end, Gilbert had 15 points. He was 7 of 12 from field. At one point, he was 7 of 9 and then cooled off at the end. In fact, UAA cooled off as a group, just one of their last 7 shots from the field. 7 points for Barrientos. He also had 3 assists. 4 points for Lentfer, 4 points for Harrington off the bench, 3 points for Storms, and a deuce for Satchel. So a 42-35 Viking lead. Closed out the first half, as you said, 9 of their last 10 shots, and did it defensive end. One of the things we heard from A.J. Albritton was if they get stops, that helps their offense a lot to get out and run. So that's one of the keys we'll look for in the second half as we return to the play-by-play.
Thank you,
Adam Race.
Thank you, Butch. Now, the Vikings, 42 points here, on pace to be only the second team to score 80 against this Anchorage team this year, but they also have to continue to hold up on the defensive end, and that has been an issue in the second half over this three-game losing streak, where the Vikings have given up an average of around 50 points in second-half play against St. Martin's, SPU, and MSUB. So Vikings need to shut the door on the other end. It's a great pass to start the half out from Velt. Finds Isaac Moreau.
Going to run back doors on us. We'll run back doors on you. Nice cut by Isaac Moreau and a good look
Isaac
by
Moreau
Nick
did
Velt.
Start this game, but B.J. Collin going down with an injury early in that first half. Moreau comes in, provides the energy he always does off the bench.
And it was officially noted to us as an ankle injury. Would not expect to see B.J. Collin the rest of the night.
Hopefully he can recover quickly from that as Gilbert gets the defender in the air but can't hit the shot at the end of it. Kai Johnson comes down with the board. Lead pass ahead to Wilson. Cross court finds Jonathan Ned. Quick movement here from the Vikings. We saw in that first half Western Washington trying to push the place while UAA trying to slow things down as Moreau gets around a two-hand check from Sawyer Storms to Kai Johnson who hits the three and one.
Johnson checked his ankle but seemed to be okay as well. And he got caught on the closeout. The shot goes down. You can see if he, just as he lands, gets tripped a little bit. But Kai Johnson on his way to a big night here. This could be his 18th point just a minute into the second half.
He's unable to complete the four-point play, unfortunately. But Kai Johnson, as you said, is at 17 right now. He's had a few 30 bombs this year already.
Averaging 21.4 coming in.
At least 10 points in every single game this season. Barrientos kicks it out to Gilbert and swatted away by Kai Johnson running the transition and laying it in. And the Vikings started the second half hot now after ending the first half hot. They're on a 10-0 run, 29-7 run over the last 7 minutes.
14-point lead.
Barrientos receives the pass, drives in, can't get the layup around Nick Velp. Vikings the other way with speed. Jonathan Ned straight to the hoop.
Ooh.
Yes.
A little finger roll. Very nice.
At full
Very
speed.
Nice.
The Carver Crazies are excited, and Rusty Osborne is forced to take a timeout. First media just 2 minutes into this second half. We'll be right back with the Vikings up 35-51.
To them, the whole world looks like an opportunity, one to be seized, built upon, and made better for their sport and the people around it. To student athletes, every opportunity is a chance to change what could be and show the world what opportunity can do.
Welcome back. A Viking 12-0 run. Jonathan Ned with the most recent field goal in that driving, drifting away, and then that little finger roll off the board, squeezing in. 15 points for Jonathan Ned, 6 of 9 from the floor. And maybe the key thing is the Vikings getting out in transition and accelerating the pace of this game. They've got a 16-point lead.
The Vikings right now are doing everything right. I mean, this was the one thing we weren't sure they'd be able to do is score with efficiency against one of the most elite defenses in Division II. They've done that so far. The response there on a quick elbow pull-up from Dathan Satchel. Johnson hands it off to Velt, now back to Moreau. Vikings setting up a play here, a screen around Moreau. They get it to Jonathan Ned, down low, and back up to Velt. Fake the three, drives inside, in the paint, floater, no good. Gets his own rebound twice, can't get it to go, though. And Leffner comes down with the board at the end of it. Tyson Gilbert up top, quick pull-up by Dathan Satchel. That one's off the mark, a quick release, but no good. Jonathan Ned straight the other way. Euro stepping his way to the basket.
6'9 guy leading the break and just daring people to get in front of him. Great finishes by Jonathan Ned.
The Vikings have been so efficient on the transition tonight. That's going to be a foul there. Isaac Moreau is going to pick it up, his third. That is just such a pretty basket right
shimmy,
there.
A little shake. He's not 5'9", he's 6'9".
And since he's come here transferring over from the University of Georgia, he's shown his ability to run the floor like a guard despite his size.
He has had some point guard background, and it shows.
Jonathan Ned also having an excellent three-point shooting year as Gilbert is off with a three of his own. Grant Holiday pulls down the board.
Well, he's missed five straight shots now after that great start.
One of their last eight are the Seawolves. And the call there will be a blocking foul, I believe.
No, it is going to go the other way.
It's going to be a charge on Will Wilson, you're right. Getting there in time was Tyson Gilbert. Draw the contact.
That's probably a good call.
Tony Dominguez discussing with the referee on that one.
That was a very pleasant little discussion. Everybody less smiling, so.
We've definitely seen Tony Dominguez more irate. That pass into Barrientos. Can't handle it. Out of bounds. A turnover, something that this Seawolves team is so good at avoiding.
Western got away with one there. See, if you let that guard make that cut through without bodying it up and forcing him away, that's danger. But Barrientos dropped the pass.
This is a team with a turnover margin of +4. Best in the GNAC. Johnson. Scoop pass finds Nick Velp. And that foul is going to go against Jaron Williams.
Yeah, a little bit of a bump there.
Third foul against Williams. Inbounded to Will Wilson. Driving in, spin move into the paint, fading away and putting it in.
Will Wilson. He's been quiet tonight, but he hasn't missed. 7 points.
Wilson coming off an efficient night last week against SPU. This has been a game in which the Vikings haven't sprouted the scoring as much as we've seen as Jaron Williams goes straight the other way, backs down Kai Johnson and puts it in.
And you wouldn't expect it to, right? The pace is going to be slower because it is going to take a little more time. They are a good defensive team. So if you can get to 80 on this night, that's a good mark. And I understand the Vikings are averaging 93, but to get to 80 against this team is an accomplishment.
And that'll lead to a timeout here, 55-39. Vikings still holding on to a very nice lead. We'll be right back on Vikings TV.
Welcome back. Earlier this evening, the Western Washington University women's basketball team claimed a 52-49 victory at St. Martin's. A very weird game. The Vikings led 6-5 at the end of the first quarter and 17-14 at halftime. Went right down to the wire. Olivia Wickstrom, the only player in double figures for Western, off the bench with 14 points. Olivia Rios had, Kiana Rios, had 16 off the bench for St. Martin's. The Vikings ranked 14th in one national poll, 21st in the other, and now 13-3 and 5-1 in the GNAC. A gutty win for Western down in Lacey tonight.
Not the prettiest one, but they all count the same, watching that in pregame here in Carver Gym. A little too much excitement in that one, but able to pull it out in the end. Kai Johnson throws up a shot as he got fouled. I believe he is going to go to the line for it. Not a shot that had a chance of going in, but it does send him to the charity stripe. He's so good at reacting to that foul and just throwing something up so he gets the line.
It's James Harden-esque.
Absolutely.
It's probably just as well I wasn't on camera for the Harden impersonation there.
Johnson hits the first one. And Butch, I've talked to some people who have played pickup basketball with you, and they've said that you have James Harden-like ability. I don't know if they're telling the truth or not.
I don't know if I can actually hit a step back. I can knock down a jumper, but I don't know if I could actually throw you that step back and get fouled that way.
57-39. Vikings have opened up a very comfortable lead right now as Jordan Tate hits the deck. Tyson Gilbert cuts into that lead with a good lay-in. Pass is tipped, but does find Will Wilson in the corner. Rolls out.
I'm sorry. I jinxed Will Wilson. Said he hadn't missed. He's missed.
Will Wilson, 2 of 3 now. 7 points. Sawyer Storms is going to go to the line there.
Nifty little feed by Gilbert there. The up fake. And
first trip to the line tonight for the Seawolves.
Wow. They don't shoot a ton of them, about 14 a night, but still a surprise.
Not the team's strength, just 60%, a bit above that on the year.
66, yeah, that's not great. Old Western coach Brad Jackson and many other coaches before and since who said fake a pass to make a pass. And we saw Tyson Gilbert do there. The up fake and then a little downshift with a bounce pass. Very fundamental little move there.
The offense hasn't been perfect this year for the Seawolves, but as far as distribution goes, they've been very good.
Well, and again, except for the foul line, you know, they shoot a reasonable percentage, particularly given that they shoot a fairly high number of threes. And the fact that they don't score a lot is as much a function of the fact that they play slow. I mean, it'd be interesting to do the numbers and see what they do on point. Look,
oh, my goodness. Oh, it's not able to be finished off there.
On
a beautifully set up lob.
Wow.
And straight down the other way, a three-pointer is hit by Dathan Satchel. That almost brought the roof down. The lob to Jonathan Ned, just not able to send it in. And that will lead to a timeout. We're going to stay here for it, 46-57. Just a 30-second timeout. So an 18-point lead cut down to an 11 now.
Well, that's a big swing right there, right? Because you're up 14, and you've got a lob dunk that you miss. And they go to the other side, and you've been back up 16, and now it's 11.
That's about as big of a momentum swing as you can get.
That's, yeah.
And this
I thought for sure that thing was down. The pass was good. Ned seemed to have it timed right. It just got a little bit of the iron and kicked out.
And this is a high-flying Western team, a team that has cycled out with this new recruiting class, brought in a lot of bigger players, players with that kind of hops, and it was a great pass as well from Kai Johnson. Great lead pass from Will Wilson. It was really just a very well-done play just off on the finish. Grant Holiday inbounds it here after the 30-second timeout. Tony Dominguez just talking things over with his team. Kai Johnson hands it off to Ned. Right back to Johnson. Drives baseline. Pull-up jumper. No good. Rebounded by Storms. Vikings now one of their last four after the red-hot streak they had at the end of the first and beginning of the second half. 6 minutes gone in the last period of play here. Barrientos driving a Jonathan Ned, kicking it to the corner, and getting fouled in the corner is going to be Dathan Satchel. Kai Johnson got into the landing space, and Satchel will shoot a trio of free throws. Second foul on a three-point attempt we've seen here tonight. Dathan Satchel made 6 threes in his last game. Scored a season-high 24 points. He's an 8.6 point per game player. Senior guard misses the first. Transfer from Los Positas Community College, Tracy, California native.
You know where Tracy is?
Could not tell you that I do.
Okay.
You're always quizzing me on the geography. You always get me on it.
Yeah. We haven't gotten the whole Tyler, Texas thing yet. Tracy is south of Stockton on I-5, I think. Not, you know, just kind of east of the Bay Area in the Central Valley there.
One of a few California exports on this Seawolves team. His career, he's an efficient shooter. He's having a bit of a down year, shooting in the 30s as far as field goal percentage goes, but a similar three-point percentage to his field goal percentage. He checks out now, replaced by Hassan Harrington.
From this, who is the transfer from UT Tyler. The men's coach, the current men's coach, he wasn't the coach when Hassan Harrington was there. Tim Moser, was the former women's coach at Anchorage.
Ned pulls up for three there and hits it with a hand in his face. Jonathan Ned is feeling it right now. He's up to 20 points on 8 of 12 shooting. That's his third triple.
He and Kai Johnson have combined for 41 of the 60. They have been huge tonight.
Tron Williams kicks it into the corner to Harrington. Back to Williams for three, and the response is there from the Anchorage native. And now it's just a 9-point game. Tijon Sain into the game, pulls it up the floor. Works around a screen from Grant Holiday. Sain yet to pull up a shot here today. He has gone to the line. Grant Holiday passes it back off to Sain, the redshirt freshman. Drives in, kicks it to the corner. Ned wants another one. Can't get it. Rebounded by Storms. Seawolves working, oh, the other way. A 3-on-1 transition. Somehow they keep it in bounds, and Dron Williams is able to get a hold on it, but it's stolen away by Louis Grant Holiday. And he's going to be fouled in transition. Once again, we see Grant Holiday get the steal and run it fast in transition. He'll go to the line.
Yeah, nice pick there by Louis Granty Holiday. Bumped along the way, so it will be a sideline idea. They didn't actually get that first bump. We see where the trigger will come from here.
The whistle came early, and they played through to him driving to the basket. As Sain goes in and he draws a foul. He goes against Sawyer Storms. Third foul against him. Fifth team foul on the half for UAA, 16th on the night. Vikings just 10 fouls on the night. Only player in foul trouble for the Vikings is Moreau. Sain hits the first near a 90% free throw shooter. Sends the lead back up to 10. Vikings led by as much as 18. They push it back up to 11 here. But they have a tendency on this losing streak they're on right now to give up a lot of points in the second half. Tron Williams pass it off to Trey Evans. Back to Williams, 15 on the shot clock. Throws it down to Storms. They find the corner three from Harrington. Won't go. One-handed rebound pulled down by Kai Johnson, sprinting down the other way off to Tijon Sain. Looked up, thought about a three, didn't pull the trigger. Sain fakes the pass to the red-hot Jonathan Ned. Gives it off instead to Kai Johnson. 10 to shoot. Working against Harrington. Got his defender in the air, and one! That's as good as it gets right there from Kai Johnson. Got the defender Hassan Harrington to jump on the pump fake. Drew the foul as he was on the way down and netted it.
So under control.
And that'll force a timeout from UAA. So the Vikings up 64-51 when we return.
Welcome back. The Vikings holding a 64-51 lead here with just a couple ticks under 12 minutes to go, doing it mostly behind the efforts of Kai Johnson and Jonathan Ned. Kai with 23 points. I go to the line looking for his 24th. Ned with 20, so 43 of the 64. And as you mentioned, you know, second half defense has been a key element in this, the struggle second half defense in this three-game losing streak, but they've held UAA to 16 points here in the second half, so not too bad compared to maybe those last few contests.
One thing that UAA has been able to improve on is their three-point shooting in this second half, getting a couple from Nathan Satchel as Kai Johnson's unable to complete the three-point play. Seawolf are 3 of 15 from beyond the arc in the first half. They're 2 of 5 so far here in the second. Son Harrington gets it off to Dron Williams. Pulls up mid-range from the baseline and gets it.
He slipped. Looked like he was going to turn his ankle. And he just kind of glided out of it and hit a 16-footer.
Nothing but net. Nick Velp prepared to come back in for Western Washington.
It looked so awkward and became so smooth. It was really nice.
I didn't even notice it. That puts in how smooth it was as the ball is lost there by Isaac Moreau. Diving to the floor to pick it back up are the Seawolves. Vikings have been better about the turnovers in this second half than they have been in the first. Tyson Gilbert kicks it back out to Jerron Williams. Fakes the three-pointer, takes the two-pointer, can't get it, and there's going to be a foul on the rebound that will be against, I believe, Jerron Williams there. Yes, that is Jerron Williams on the foul. Either that or Kai Johnson, excuse me.
Kai Johnson, I think, yeah.
Sorry, yes, it is Kai Johnson. I saw Jerron Williams angry there. I thought it was against him, but it was against Johnson on the rebound.
I think Williams might have wanted a foul on the shot there.
I see. Tyson Gilbert to inbound. Gets it into Harrington. Trey Evans, the freshman, working against the redshirt freshman, Sane. Pass it down inside to Williams. 10 on the shot clock. Fadeaway jumper is too strong. Picked up by Nick Velp. 11 points separate these two teams. Two teams with a boatload of talent trying to establish themselves in a competitive GNAC this season. Meanwhile, the battle at the top of the GNAC standings between MSUB and St. Martin's. Right now, St. Martin's up 27-25 as the offensive foul there.
Certainly contact. We can't see the arc or anything there, so.
Will Wilson's second foul. Losing his footing there for a second was Harrington, but he stays on that pivot. Gives it up to Gilbert. Guarded by Moreau at the top of the perimeter. Pulls up for three. No good. Rebounded by Leffner, and he gets it to go on the putback. Excuse me, that was Lyman Simmons on the rebound and two-point score. Simmons' first bucket of the night, just as he comes off the bench for the first time in this game. Wilson working against Simmons, gets some space on the tween, can't get the jump shot to go, rebounded by Velp. He can't get his two-point shot to go. And the Seawolves sprinting down in transition. They get a corner three contested and a foul.
Every time!
You might be able to hear on the mic there, Tony Dominguez not too happy about that one. Tyson Gilbert will go to the line to shoot three. Tijon Sain flying in.
He's got the little Walter Davis Lloyd World B free kick out on his jumper, and he has it all the time. It's not, but he kicked out, and Tijon Sain ran right through the kick out.
Gilbert falling forward on the free throw line, can't hit it. Now, this is a UAA team that won the Alaska rivalry game in OT by 2 points in a game where they made less than half of their free throws. I believe it was 14 of 26 they were from the line, still able to win that game against the rival Nanooks. They've only gone to the line a handful of times so far tonight. They've all been in the second half. And he gets two of them.
What, two of them have been on three-point attempts, right? And three trips to the line, two of them on three while attempting threes.
Very unorthodox numbers from the charity stripe, but they're 6 of 8. Tijon Sain with it.
Western just 10 of 15.
Pass it off to Will Wilson, 10 to shoot. Guarded by Trey Evans, drives to his right side, straight to the hoop. And that's going to be an and one for Will Wilson. So right back at the other end, Will Wilson a chance for a three-point play. He's had a quiet start to the night, hasn't had too many shots.
Aggressive take by Will Wilson, the defender. Gets there, but I'm pretty certain Harrington was inside the arc there, and thus the and one for Will Wilson.
Breaks nearly a 3-minute scoreless streak for Western Washington as UAA had brought this one to a very close margin.
It was down to 7. Wilson now can get it back to double digits if he can knock down the free throw. 9 points tonight for Will Wilson.
Dathan Satchel checks back in for Hassan Harrington. Satchel has provided some energy here in this second half, hitting a three-pointer and going to the line on a foul on a three-point play as Will Wilson completes it. Jonathan Ned sitting on 20 points and currently ready to come back in. Dayton Satchel hands it off to Jerron Williams, guarded by Sain. Back out to Tyson Gilbert. Quick movement here on the perimeter from UAA, and they pay it off with the triple from Dathan Satchel off the bench, his second of the night. They're now 3 of 7 from beyond the arc in the second half after going 3 of 15 in the first half. Pass off to Kai Johnson. Euro steps in. He caught a shot up in the face, and he's shaken up. Euro stepping in between a crowd of Seawolves, and he looks like he caught an arm or an elbow up by the eye. It can't feel good, but he'll go to the line. Jonathan Ned comes in for Tijon Sain.
He's taken a couple hits tonight. Here you see this one here. And, ouch.
Tough.
This is a 1-1, but he did knock it down.
Took a shot to the eye. Seems to have not affected his depth perception on that textbook free throw.
The good shooters can close their eyes from the line, right?
Absolutely. Kai Johnson certainly among that group. Hits them both with ease. Jerron Williams brings it up the floor. 9-point difference with just under 8.5 remaining. Drives in against Nick Velp. Now kicks it all the way back out to Trey Evans.
And even down 9, still willing to be patient here.
Running a long set, shot clock down to 10 once again. Tyson Gilbert gets to the elbow, kicks it back out now to Trey Evans. Nowhere to go with it, hands it off to Jerron Williams. Tried to go behind the back and looks like they're just going to get a shot off, but it's short. A rushed shot doesn't fall. Kai Johnson ahead to Will Wilson, stumbling to the hoop, but can't get it to go in the end. And immediately you see that long 30-second possession from UAA and Western taking the first shot they can get, just not coming out that time. They get it to the corner of the hot hand, Dathan Satchel. He's off the mark that time, though. The three-point shooting has come from Satchel. He's got 2 here. He's taken 6. Both of those have come here in this second half.
And even with the improvement, still just 6 of 23 from 3 for the Seawolves.
Seawolves make the fourth most three-pointers in the GNAC. Nick Velt drives in, and he gets it to go. A tough bucket around Evans.
Satchel didn't want to leave Will Wilson open in the corner, and so he left the paint, and it left Nick Velt a driving lane to get the finish. 6 points, 8 rebounds for Nick Velt.
Best rebounder on this Vikings team. Bit of a slow scoring night for him, as that three-pointer is off the mark. A chase for the rebound there, and they're going to give it to UAA. And the Vikings bench were pretty sure that that one went off of Lyman Simmons. They might take another look at it as we go to a media timeout here with the Vikings up 11.
The Teaching Learning Academy is an organization that's housed in the library, and it's where people come to have conversations.
They deal with serious issues that have emotional impact in ways that are typically not found in a class.
We've talked about diversity and inclusivity on our campus and in our community.
It not only enriches my education, but also impacts the ways that I can continue my leadership roles.
Vikings holding on to an 11-point lead here. Tony Dominguez trying to coach his group to what would be an impressive win against a very talented UAA squad, well coached. And right now they put up 71. They're on pace to score more points than any opponent has against the Seawolves this season, that top mark being SPU, who dropped 80 on them in the second GNAC contest of this season.
It's one of the problems for the Seawolves is after a good start, Dylan Barrientos has gone very quiet. He had at least 5 quick points. He had 7 in the first half. He's yet to score here in 13 minutes of the second half. So
Barrientos had 3 of his top 5 scoring performances over his last 3 games. Coming into this one, he approached a triple-double against Central Washington, but the Vikings have kept him very quiet. They've looked instead to players like Tyson Gilbert. So foul's going to be called there against Nick Velt.
Yeah, that's a tough matchup for Nick Velt to guard the very quick, shifty Tyson Gilbert out on the perimeter.
Gilbert at 19 points on 8 of 17 shooting. Gilbert's going to go to the line to shoot 1-on-1.
And you got the commentary on the officiating from Nick Velt quite clearly there.
He does hit the first. Gilbert's taken 17 shots. Next most shots taken has been from Satchel. He's taken 8, and it's just 18 minutes. Yeah.
Gilbert started 7 of 9, as we said. Just 1 of 8 since. But now getting to the line a little bit. Got the 3-point foul earlier, and then knocks down 2 free throws here.
It's 4 of 5 from the line.
Seawolves 8 of 10.
3-pointer in transition from Will Wilson. Oh. Put right back in by Kai Johnson.
It's like just laid hung it there in. And waited for the ball to come to him.
That is the literal definition of a layup. He just let it fall in off his hand.
27 for Kai Johnson.
Losing the ball there on the handle was Williams, but it's picked up. Williams got the defender in the air, no foul, and he misses the shot. Chasing after the rebound, falling out of bounds and into the stands.
They're going to get Kai Johnson with the foul here.
He was bumped into the first row by Kai Johnson, battling for that rebound as we look again at this putback.
Very nice. Just
soft hands.
That is Kai Johnson's 4th foul. So the Vikings with an 11-point lead, but their leading scorer on the bench with 4 fouls.
And very unfortunate. The Vikings only 15 team fouls. Only other player with more than 2 is Isaac Moreau, but their leading scorer, Kai Johnson, in serious foul trouble right now with 6 minutes remaining. Tony Dominguez is going to save him for the last minutes of this game. Of course, want to give him as many minutes as possible every single game. Ron Williams hits a couple from the line, cut it down to 9 points again. Vikings led by as much as 18, but it's been around 9 or 10 for a while now. Seawolves hanging around. Will Wilson, jab step, trying to get around Tyson Gilbert. Euro stepping in and putting it in off the glass.
Good take by Will Wilson.
Back up to 11. Barrientos passes it off now to Sawyer Storms. Back to Gilbert. Gilbert cross it over to his left side to the basket. There's going to be a foul there. Looks like they're going to get Isaac Moreau. And that will be his fourth foul. Moreau, who's had to play extended minutes here with the early injury to B.J. Cauley. He's on 21 minutes now. Nobody getting ready to come back in for Moreau right now, so Tony Dominguez is going to leave him out there. Gilbert hits the first. Only player who's shot more free throws in this game than Tyson Gilbert is Kai Johnson. Now there is going to be a change for the Vikings as Moreau will check out for Darius Gary coming in.
Tyson Gilbert, who only averages about a little over 2.5 free throws a game, has gotten in line a lot tonight. This will now be his seventh attempt.
Hits them both. Good overall game for him. 23 points, 4 rebounds, 2 assists, and a steal.
A little bit of three-quarter court pressure. Western gets through it fairly easily.
Bijan Sain running the point, hands it off to Gary. Yet to pull up a shot. We know Darius Gary has that three-point shot and ability to drive in. 8 on the shot clock. Jonathan Ned pulls up from the top. That one's left short and rebounded by Dathan Satchel. Gilbert straight down the other way. Hands it off to Satchel. Quick pull-up three. That one is short. Satchel tried to get to the rebound, but it ends up in the hands of Tijon Sain, who slows it down here. 5 minutes left here in a lead. Vikings perhaps a little bit slower on the offensive end than we're used to seeing them. Certainly had an opportunity to take a quick shot on that possession, but instead running a play. Tijon Sain driving in, turnaround, fadeaway.
Oh.
Yes, that's a pretty shot there from Tijon Sain.
That was not easy.
His first shot of the night falls. On the other end, Jaron Williams is guarded by Darius Gary, drives in on his right side, straight to the hoop, can't get it to go, and he's going to get a foul. Williams' second trip to the line tonight. Hit his first two. So look again at this make by Tijon Sain. When he first put that shot up, I thought that perhaps wasn't the best shot they could get on that possession, but he's a gifted shooter, and he made it work.
Boy, hit over the much taller defender in the 6'3", Dathan Satchel.
Satchel has hit a couple of three-pointers. He's got the second most points on the Seawolves with 12, but he's missed a couple in a row now. Williams hits the second. 10 points is the difference. Long pass isn't going to get to Grant Holiday, but it just goes out of bounds harmlessly off the hands of Sawyer Storms. Frustrated he couldn't get to that.
Good anticipation by Storms. He just couldn't keep the ball in play there.
It was certainly an optimistic pass by Will Wilson trying to find Grant Holiday. Gets away with it, though, in the end. Sain guarded by Barrientos. Hands it off now to Will Wilson. Drives in, splitting the defense, getting to the corner. Grant Holiday for three. He gets the foul and the three-pointer. Now, this is interesting, the amount of fouls on three-point shots we've seen in this game.
Can we say this? Stop fouling three-point shooters.
Just getting into his landing space there. It's a foul, really, you should be able to avoid.
And that's just not a particularly sound closeout. Right at him, and he's trying to make a play, obviously, but it's probably better there to fly by him rather than to go straight at him.
And able to finish the four-point play was Grant Holiday. Barrientos, now we're talking about how he was getting slow, but he pulled up with a lot of confidence
there. About an hour
there.
And 15 minutes, and he just comes down and drills a three.
Straight off the jump.
10 points, 4 assists for Dylan Barrientos.
81 points for the Vikings is the most that the Seawolves have given up this season, and it's not a huge surprise that an offense like the Vikings is the one to do it, but an impressive feat nonetheless. Team that's just giving up 60.5 points per game coming into tonight. Losing the dribble is Jonathan Nett. It's taken away by Storms. 2-on-1 here in the transition. Great defense by Will Wilson there on the 2-on-1, denying Hassan Harrington. And we'll go to immediate timeout here with the Vikings up 11. We'll be right back on Vikings TV for the last 3.5.
I would summarize my experience at Western as I was a guarded, nerdy kid who loved to perform, who allowed herself to put in the time and effort to carve herself into something.
Jump in the trunk, jump in the trunk,
And whatever that was has led me to where I am right now, to be a fully realized woman. And I'm really thankful for the time and the effort that I put in for myself, because if I didn't do it, no one else was going to.
Somewhere buried behind all those people is Kai Johnson, who has checked back in and will be back on the floor despite picking up his fourth foul. Kai Johnson with 27 points tonight, matching his third highest output of the year. He had 36 against George Fox. He had 31 against St. Martin's, and then 27 at Cal Poly Humboldt early in the season. So a great night for him, a great night for Jonathan Ned as well, with 20 points, and they have been the key as the Vikings go into the last 3.5 minutes here with an 81-70 lead. Back with the play-by-play is Adam Race.
Thank you, Butch. Kai Johnson at 27 points. Last time he was in Carver Gym, that 30 bomb he drew up on SMU. Wasn't able to win the battle against a great game by Kyle Greeley, and altogether excellent performance by just an outstanding SMU team. Long lollipop pass ahead. Now they get it to the corner to Storms for threes. Long on it, and it's rebounded by Jonathan Ned. That's a big stop for the Vikings out of the timeout.
So now at this point, the roles shift. The Vikings want to work clock here, and UAA is going to have to play faster than what they've played most of the night.
Seawolves in less than comfortable territory, pushing the tempo. Dijon Sain with the ball here. 10 on the shot clock. Vikings, as Butch said, are going to try to run down the shot clock as much as they can. Under 3 minutes on the game clock. Kai Johnson pulls up for three. Can't get it. Rebounded by Jonathan Ned. Sain left open for three. No, can't get it. And you're not going to see Dijon Sain miss too many open three-pointers.
Going to get a foul and a rebound here. I'm going to call it on Tyson Gilbert. And Louis Grant Holiday will get two free throws as we are in the double bonus. Louis Grant Holiday on the season, an 81% free throw shooter, not a big number of them, 13 of 16.
Grant Holiday has been a really good presence in this game off the bench. He's gotten a couple of steals. He's gone 3 of 3 from the field with a three-pointer.
He's kind of settled in over the last few weeks, hasn't he? Early in the year, in tight games, he wasn't seeing big minutes, but his time has gone on, his role has grown, and he's been a very proficient player off the bench for the Vikings.
And this is a much deeper Vikings team than we've seen in a couple previous seasons, a great recruiting class, Grant Holiday among them.
From the southern suburbs of London.
Transfer from Seattle University, where he redshirted last year. Jaron Williams, good move to get some space and lay it in there, up and over. Making an 11-point game with 2.5 remaining. Sain hands it off to Johnson, splits the defense, hands it off to Ned. Pressure defense here from UAA, trying to get a swat and a steal. Dijon Sain, he's going to be blocked driving in there. Jaron Williams running it quickly down the other way, all the way in. Blocked away by Isaac Moreau, and it's going to go the Vikings' way.
Yeah, it looked like it went off the hand of Sawyer Storms. Two great blocks at both ends, right? And Williams first and then Moreau. And we'll see the second as Williams goes to the rack, and Moreau just waits him out, blocks the shot, and that's actually off Williams' hands, I think. Viking ball.
Viking's able to beat the press and go the other way. Grant Holiday lays it up and in. Going to the ground with Sawyer Storms, but no whistle.
13 points for Louis Grant Holiday, 4-for-4 from the field, including a 3, and 4-for-4 from the foul line.
Huge performance from the redshirt freshman. Three-pointer there by Perrientos. He's hit a couple quickly, and he brings it back to a 10-point game. Tijon Sain gets beyond him, lays it off to Moreau, swatted from behind, and that's going to be a foul on Perrientos. Would have been an impressive chase down block, but he caught too much of the hand of Isaac Moreau there.
With the weather as it is, a rather small crowd, if a coach gets up and really yells, you're going to hear every word of it. And
as Moreau misses a couple, and it's going to be UAA ball. Yeah, I was going to say, we don't have to do much talking in the breaks here. The coaches are doing the talking.
Rusty Osborne was very clear how he didn't think that was the right call. Fair enough.
Well, some might say, ball don't lie, as Moreau not able to hit the free throws. Pass just gets beyond the reach of Grant Holiday, spinning to the hoop there and laying it in. Good move there by Sawyer Storms. And all of a sudden, this is back down to an 8-point game with a minute 12 remaining. Vikings need to bear down here. One of their last four from the field. A 5-0 run for the visiting Alaska Anchorage Seawolves. Vikings trying to snap a 3-game losing streak. Ned from three. Yes! Jonathan Ned has been hot all night. He spent some time on the bench, comes back in, and hits a huge one, perhaps a dagger here as it goes to 11 points. That shot is short. Rebounded by Kai Johnson.
That is probably going to do it.
Anchorage not fouling. The Vikings might be on their way to a really impressive victory.
Oh, and an important victory. Snap the 3-game losing streak and get a bit of momentum back. The team, as we said earlier, is probably, by the numbers, no official poll, regional poll yet, but by the numbers, a team that's on the bubble region, you know, for the regional tournament. And you bounce back and get a win like this, and full credit to Kai Johnson and Jonathan Ned. Johnson gets the first, now 28 points. Ned with 23. Will Wilson with 12 and a big contribution off the bench. Louis Grant Holiday, 13 points, a couple of big steals, huge contribution.
UAA is going to snap a winning streak of their own. Driving in there is Dron Williams. Lays it up and in. The timeout is called by Rusty Osborne. That will just be a 30-second timeout. Vikings coming off of a frustrating road trip. You know, they played against an MSUB team and did well against a defensively-minded MSUB team, but weren't able to hold up on the defensive end their own. Of course, losing the rivalry match in the Brome Pavilion against SPU, but now be able to come back home and beat an Anchorage team that's one of the best defenses in the nation. What does that do for a team coming off of this streak?
Your momentum is what you do in the next game, right? It doesn't mean anything if you don't come back and beat Fairbanks on Saturday. It's a great performance, but if you're going to be at the top of the conference, you've got to back it up. And this is a great win, no doubt about it, and it breaks the slide. And if you come out of this and win both of them this weekend, then you can kind of talk about the momentum you got and where you're rolling.
Quick turnover here on the other end, and it's laid in. All of a sudden, it's a 9-point game. Maybe we're talking too soon. Probably not. Just want to cover all my bases here. Tony Dominguez still not happy with how that is being run in the backcourt there.
Really quickly around the GNAC and the men's side, Seattle Pacific up 77-45 at Western Oregon with about 7 minutes to go. And an interesting one, Billings and St. Martin. St. Martin's up 51-47 with 9.5 to go.
A huge matchup there between SMU and MSUB. Two top teams in the conference, two of the top West Region teams. Grant Holiday hits that one. He is now perfect from the field and the line as Kai Johnson sliding in with 13 seconds to grab a steal. That just shows the intensity that he has.
So they're trying to roll about the floor, as teams do, right? And you're trying to save time on the clock. And Kai Johnson saw it and dove in and slid about the last 6 feet to steal it and force a tie-up.
It doesn't even go down as a steal.
No.
But still, very impressive.
I hope somebody puts that on a highlight film.
Oh, put back dunk.
And maybe
there.
Somebody will put that on a highlight film, too. Sawyer storms.
That's an impressive dunk, but that's going to do it. 92-83, the final score. A very good win for Western Washington as they go to 3-3 in the GNAC and break the three-game skid. Alaska Anchorage go to 3-3 and lose their four-game winning streak. This was an excellent all-around offensive performance, as we've seen all season.
29 points for Kai Johnson, 23 for Jonathan Ned. The Vikings shoot 57% from the field and 10 of 20 from three-point range. Huge effort offensively and a solid effort defensively as well for a 92-83 victory.
10 of 20 from three-point range against a team that was just giving up a 25% three-point percentage on the season, best in Division II.
And we should note at the other end, a really great performance from Tyson Gilbert. He finished with 25 points as well, played all 40 minutes.
We're in a second here, going to get an interview between Zen Hill and Jonathan Ned. But thank you for tuning in here. I've been Adam Rice alongside Butch Kameen on Vikings TV. We'll send it over to Zen.
I'm joined here postgame with Jonathan Ned, Vikings player of the game. 23 points for you, but mainly the victory against a tough Alaska Anchorage team. Talk to me about the game. Talk to me about the victory. What does it mean to you?
We've been really harping just playing together as a team, so I think we really showed that today. You know, we lost three in a row, so it's good to get back in the win column tonight.
You and Kai Johnson kind of had, you know, the leading scoring tonight. It's kind of like you guys got that 1-2 connection on the court as well. He's driving and kicking you in the corner, it seems like, every time you're knocking down that shot. Talk about the connection between you two star players.
Me and Kai have been playing for a while, so, you know, there's really going down today. We just had to be a little more aggressive today. And, you know, luckily we pulled out the W, so that's all that matters.
You guys got Alaska Fairbanks on Saturday. What's the mindset? What's the game plan going into that one?
Pretty much the same thing, you know, just play hard, play together, and that takes care of everything, so.
One last question for you. You guys shot the ball very efficiently, and you proved against a tough defense why you're the top scoring team in the entire conference. Talk about what was successful on offense.
We really just took our time today. We was patient, and we got a lot more open looks today, which obviously is going to increase your shooting percentage. We wasn't taking as many tough shots today, so.
Yeah. All right, thank you, Ned. Yeah, great game. Good luck on Saturday. You can catch the Vikings on Saturday against Alaska Fairbanks on Vikings TV. We'll see you next time.